Everyone, welcome to our very first Cambridge United Community Trust Virtual After School Club. My name's Ash and I'm the Primary Education Manager for the Trust and I'm also a Pre-Academy and Elite RDC coach. I hope you enjoy your first session today, but before we begin, it's really important that we just pause and take a moment to reflect and remember those that fought and died for us during World War One. Okay, so basically in this session, different people are going to take you through different exercises and we'd love for you to join in, whether it's from an indoor space or out in your garden. All you'll need today for the whole session is one ball and up to five cones or markers or anything that you can put down that sort of shows you how you can mark it out. I'm going to get started now with a warm-up. It's about 4 to 5 minutes long. Let's get to it. Okay, so here we are out in my garden, ready for our warm-up. We need some good warm-up music, so I'm gonna use my magic football to choose a song. Here we go. No, that's not gonna work. Try another one. Oh, that's even worse. Hold on. That's better. Here we go. You ready? So we're gonna start doing some running on the spot. My timer's on. Here we go. Jogging on the spot. We're going to do about 30 seconds of this.
Let's go.
You can go a little bit faster if you want to push yourself. Slow it down if you need to. 15 seconds, we're going to switch to high knees. Okay, we're just running on the spot. Here we go, 10 more seconds. Try and keep off your heels, I always say that to my coach. And we go to high knees now, 30 seconds. Make sure you breathe as you go. Keep pushing yourself, don't need a warm up. Keep it going, 15 seconds. Make sure those knees are nice and high. And go, 10 seconds. Here we come. We're gonna go to heel kicks now. Go. Nice and high heels. Keep off those heels. Breathing as you go. Doing good, doing really good. 15 left. Ten seconds left. We're gonna move to star jumps. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, star jumps. Sit nice and big. So let's keep breathing. So, 2, 1. Few more. Right, now we're gonna do run and touch, run and touch, run and touch. A few steps back, a few steps forward.
2, 1, go! 10 seconds left. Then I'm gonna go to crisscross squats. Hard to say three times fast. Bang, bang, down. Bang, bang, down. Crisscross squat. Crisscross squat. Try and get nice and low. Got two more. Okay, next we're using our football and we're going to do TikToks, side to side touches. Keep your eye on the ball to keep concentration. Come on. 10 seconds. And our last one, we're going to pump the ball with touches on the top. Go. Start slow, get faster, and you get more confident. Three, two, one, go. Ten seconds left. You can do it. And relax. Well done, everyone. Back to me. Well, I hope you enjoyed that warm-up. And I guess you're a lot fitter than I am. I need to practice that. Anyway, we're gonna move on with our session now. Our first part of our session is led by Elite RDC Manager Chris, and he's gonna be working with you on your close control. So watch the video, and then you'll get the opportunity to practice yourself and work alongside the video that we've got out here to improve that close control. Enjoy the first part. We'll be right back.
2, 1, go!
One.
Go. For a quick drinks break, and while you're having your drink, why not enjoy the highlights of our last league game against Salford. See you soon. Okay, I hope you had a nice drinks break. We're now gonna go back to Chris for part two of today's close control session, and it's gonna get a little bit harder, so make sure you watch carefully.
Go! Here
Right, so something slightly different now. We're going to jump over to Louis, who is our elite goalkeeper coach. He's going to be taking you through some shot stopping today. If you're not a goalkeeper, just join in anyway. You might learn a thing or two. And if you are a goalkeeper, watch carefully and give it your best. Now it's time for your second drinks break, and while you're having your drink, check out our skip challenge from this week featuring our very own Academy product, Harry Darling.
Hello and welcome to the Mick George Skip Challenge. The rules are really simple. Each player gets 45 seconds to get as many balls as they can into the skip. But do not, and I repeat, do not hit the bags apart. Up this week for the Mick George Skip Challenge, we've got Harry Darling, one of our own. Let's see how he gets on.
Harry Darling, defender.
Not a bad effort from the centre half, Harry Darling. He got two in this week.
This part of our training session is called Squire's Skills. And it's with Sam Squire, who's a former Cambridge United player. He's now our Premier League kicks officer. He's going to take you through his skill of the day. Watch carefully and copy.
The first drill is using the sole of your feet only, okay? So we can go forwards, backwards, sideways, okay? Left and right. And I want you to use both feet and just have fun with it, okay? So be flexible, maybe do a few spins, maybe go back and then forwards, okay? So 30 seconds, let's go.
Thank you very much, Sam. I personally love to use my sole to move the ball, but I come from a futsal background, and in futsal, we often use the bottom of our foot to move the ball. Anyway, we're moving on now to a part of our after-school club called Physical Corner, where yours truly will be taking you through a physical skill that you can work on and develop. Let's see what we're doing today.
Hi there, and welcome to our latest Cambridge United Community Trust PE video. I've got Casper here, and this is what we're working on today. Hey!
Balance is the ability to stay upright or stay in control of your body movement. There are two types of balance: static, which is without travelling, and dynamic, which is when you travel. In gymnastics, static balance would need to be trained and worked on, and in many sports, particularly those that involve physical contact, dynamic balance is important to develop too, and can be built with a few simple tips. You can easily test your balance by timing yourself standing on one leg for 1 minute. Keep track of how many times your non-standing foot touches the floor. Keep track of your scores, and once you can do it for 1 minute without touching the floor at all, make it harder by trying it with your eyes closed and then on an uneven surface, like a cushion. When practicing with your eyes open, concentrate your attention on something small while balancing, without looking away from it. Practice more challenging balancing with your eyes closed so that your body engages muscles in your feet, legs, and core. Using an uneven surface, such as a cushion, will increase the work that your feet, legs, and core have to do to keep you balanced, which will make them stronger. Practice some dynamic balancing, such as hopping over a distance or one-legged jumps. Let's see how Casper got on after trying out these tips.
So Casper, have you improved your balance today?
Well done, Casper. Great work.
Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed our video. Check out some of our other content on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube.
Section of our after school club, and you're going to watch a couple of videos to inspire or educate you. And first is our word of the day, and our word of the day for today is resilience. I want you to watch this Premier League Primary Stars video on resilience and an incredible story of a team that showed resilience to succeed when nobody believed they could. Hope you enjoy the video. From an entry, give them plenty, get known for a century. Take your dream, turn to reality. Go, go, go. Hi, fella.
Hi.
You don't sound too happy. What's the problem?
Well, I lost out on my trampolining heats yesterday, which means that I won't be going through to this year's under 15 championships.
Come on, there's always next year. I'm sure you'll bounce back.
It's just that I feel like giving up after what happened. But I suppose you're right. I just have to keep working hard and believe that I can do it next year.
Yeah, just think about Leicester City Football Club.
Yeah, they were the 2016 Premier League champions, weren't they? That's an amazing story of resilience, isn't it? I mean, their success didn't just come overnight.
It was a great shock for everybody, and the story really started not at the beginning of that season, but nine games towards the end of the previous season.
Leicester City Football Club's journey from the previous season were nearly relegated to staying within the Premier League, defying all odds.
Well, I know it happened, but I still can't really believe it, because it's out there, you know, it's a great story, but it's Leicester City. It's not like you're one of the top clubs that they are supposed to win every year. Beautiful.
Leicester City's success wasn't just down to the resilience of their players, but to the belief and positive attitudes around them too.
They certainly had resilience. They also had a lot of skill. There were some very skillful players. And also the manager with his tactics was a key factor. And another key factor, I suppose, was the very supportive backroom staff, the sports analysts, the medical staff, the coaching staff.
I think there's a combination of things. You know, I think we had the momentum, definitely, and we was going in each game thinking, right, we need to win, we need to win, we need to win.
A positive mindset, Phil. That's what you need to be resilient and bounce back.
Obviously, there were also some downs when we lost away against Arsenal, which was a kind of big defeat for us because we lost in the very last second of the game. And then Arsenal, I think it was 1 point, or we were 1 point clear, 2 points clear from Arsenal. And, you know, everybody thought, OK, now they might break down. But we didn't do the favour to anybody. And at the end, we were 10 points up.
Something goes wrong, say I was in swimming and it went wrong, I would just keep on doing it, I wouldn't just stop.
If something goes wrong in sport, I ask my coaches for help and keep trying my hardest on the skill.
When I was playing football and I didn't score, so what I did was I tried and tried again.
You can have all the talent in the world, but it doesn't mean that you're going to make it to the top. It's about how you apply yourself, the determination, and the willingness to keep going when things get hard. So just keep going and believe in yourself.
I guess emotions really are important. Whether I'm feeling positive or negative will make a difference on what happens next.
That's what the Leicester City stories taught me. It's always possible to reframe your thinking and turn things around.
Thanks for helping me see that, Daniel. I'll make sure I give you a front row seat for when I make my trampolining comeback.
Wait for me.
Be inspiring.
Be connected.
Be ambitious.
Be fair.
So I hope you enjoyed that, and for me, resilience is such an important word, an important attribute in all of our development, whether we're football players or teachers or coaches, whatever we're doing, such an important word. But now we're going to jump over to our star of the day, and our star of the day for today is Imogen. And Imogen, if you didn't already know, recently completed her 7.1 million keepie-up challenge for key workers around the UK. But I will let this video explain her amazing achievement and how inspirational she's been.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yay! Well done, my darling! Fantastic!
So, I saw the wonderful Captain Tom on the news walking around his garden, and he inspired me to do something to help as well. And I thought, because I love football, I could do keepie-up.
It's really nice to do it here. I think I've been here a bunch before, and it was really amazing to actually be on this pitch. It's just really, really, really amazing.
Somebody that is as driven as her to make an impact on others through her endeavours within her challenge has just been great. It's inspired young girls in the local area, in our local schools, to pick up a football and get involved, and we're very proud of her.
Hello Imogen, Alex Scott here. Someone told me you was a fan, so I wanted to send you a quick message of support. The challenge that you are doing is incredible.
500! Thank you, Imogen. Here's your 500 keepie-ups.
2, 1.
Yeah, that's really cool to actually become a Lionheart. It's just, I can't believe it. I never thought I'd get to the 7.1 million so quickly. It's like, 7 months is a whole lot less time than 97 years. And it's just absolutely amazing how much support people have like, done, how much money we've raised. It's just absolutely amazing.
Some more keepie-uppies for my challenge. Let's do this.
She's really amazing how much support and messages of support and how much money and all of the keepie-uppies that have been donating. It's just absolutely amazing. I'm absolutely mind blown.
Okay, so here's something for you and all the family to get stuck into. It's our Move With You's community challenge. And our first challenge is to get all of our Cambridge United fans to run or walk a total of 434 kilometres from Barrow in the northwest of the country to Cambridge before we meet for our League Two match on Saturday the 14th of November. All you need to do is go out for a run with your family or by yourself, dependent on your age, and log your miles or your kilometres onto Strava. Let us know how far you've travelled. We'll add them all together and hopefully we can crack this challenge this week and get ready for next week's, which possibly could be even bigger. Okay, so well done everybody. Great session today. Remember, we are back every day at 5 o'clock through YouTube,
or our social media platforms. I'll see you back here on Friday at 5 for another training session. But for now, I'm going to start making my way to Barrow. Every step at a time, 2 kilometres. Take care, guys. See you Friday.